was growing up. I didn't really fit in. I was always known as a schoolboy in my neighborhood. I had the privilege of growing up in Harlem around some of the best art in the world. Street art, graffiti, huge murals that seemed to hug the block and embrace you as you walk the street. I was able to kind of really nerd out and explore all this art and history. For a kid like me who needed an escape from a lot of the struggles I was dealing with at home, my neighborhood, it made a huge difference. Never had an interest in coming to the Met. As a kid at 17, 18, it didn't feel like it was designed for me or it's not welcoming to me. Honestly, it took me going 100 miles away to college to actually start exploring most of the museums in my own city. I'm first in my family to go away to college. I managed to get a full tuition scholarship. My advisor, I remember, she's just like, well, you need to take this class with this guy, Teju Cole. It was Northern Renaissance art. And I'm like, what is Northern Renaissance art? The description, it was talking about like Flemish, Dutch, Netherlandish art. I was like, are you sure I should take this class? I had so many doubts. It didn't dawn on me that Teju Cole was this like world-renowned, critically acclaimed author, writer. To be quite honest, like, it really didn't matter to me. What mattered the most was like, he's a black man being in the front of the classroom. I was the only non-art history major in the class. Definitely the only black male, aside from Teju himself. He would take Dutch art or Flemish art, and then he compared the way that these artists were like really self-absorbed to like the way Kanye talked about himself. I remember at one point he had a Wiz Khalifa selfie next to like self-portrait. I would like sit in the front of the classroom, like literally like jittery, like, oh snap, like I can't believe he's doing that. It was so exciting. It felt like it was for me. Those parallels made a huge, huge difference. I found myself falling in love with the artwork, the realism, the very meticulous attention to detail that the artist gives. That really resonated with the way I've had to like live my life. I had to sharpen my attention to detail for survival growing up in my neighborhood. So on the syllabus, one of the requirements for the class is that we would take a trip to the Met with Teju. So I looked at that and I said, well, I get to go home for free. I hadn't been back in Harlem in a while, so I packed a bunch of stuff I wanted to drop off. I get off the bus with all my peers. I head uptown immediately. They enter the Met. So I'm in Harlem. I'm walking into the projects. I say what's up to my mom. I drop my bags off. I'm home, right? I'm in my neighborhood. And then I head back to the Met. I'm staring at these stairs, these big, huge stairs in the entrance of the Met. Immediately, my heart drops. I'd never been to the Met before. I still remember vividly the cold sweats, the knot in my stomach, the butterflies, and just thinking of walking into this place. Like, oh, I'm walking in here alone now. I'm gonna look so suspicious. What's security gonna think? Like, are they gonna question me? I grew up at the height of Stop and Frisk in New York City. You can imagine whenever I walked into institutions like the Met, those apprehensions and those triggers came from growing up in that kind of heightened surveillance. When I finally found my class, I witnessed something bizarre. Visitors, students, random people who were just probably passing by. Everybody was just stopped and locked in, listening to Teju explaining Hans Memling painting. I'm watching this from the outside, and I'm like, where am I right now? Having left the projects, to walk into this space where like in a sea of white faces, there's this one black man like explaining this. And all of a sudden, all this worry that I have to merge my worlds, it all just came crashing down in that moment as I witnessed that. I take this deep, deep breath of relief, and I was just like, legit, like, that could be me. Taking the class and the experience of coming to the Met became so pivotal in my own self-development and how I saw myself in all spaces after that. My first trip at the Met, I was still grappling with, do I belong in these spaces? I didn't feel comfortable or safe or secure. Which is a huge contrast from how I feel now, where I feel like I walk into any room in any institution and make it my own. I don't have to modify who I am or how I show up. I can be me. That has a lot more to do with the growth and the changes that's happened within my life and less about those places becoming inclusive. Whenever I go to a museum, it's still a confrontation. Ideally, your brain wouldn't have to work like that because it occupies space in your psyche when you really are supposed to have like a wonderful time and observe the art and love it. Now, I'm the co-founder and co-director of a national nonprofit focused on the mentorship and college persistence of young men of color. One of the ideas we have is to be able to have a museum trip every year. The work isn't so much bringing in students to walk around the Met and engage with this art. It might be beautiful, yeah, but the work is them being able to see themselves, not just in the paintings, but in the person who's talking about the paintings. The number one message I try to send to my students is not only do you belong there, but you can own that space. When you step into this place, do you feel like the artwork that's on the wall belongs to you? And for me, for the longest, it didn't. The artwork in Harlem felt like it was mine. It felt like it belonged to me. And I was always fascinated by folks who came from outside of the community and felt super comfortable navigating our spaces. They had no problem staking claims like, oh yeah, like this is just artwork for us to experience. So all this artwork belongs to me too. It's a matter of like breaking the barriers around like what we're told or conditioned or socialized to think is for us and what we're drawn to, what we're supposed to love. Like I can be from Harlem, I can be from the projects, and I can tell you about Hans Memling. And if I could do that, you can too.